go.
Hello, my name is Dan Griffith. I actually drove up, or I guess it'd be down here, from International Falls, about a 5.5-hour ride to speak last night, and again this morning, but I think, well, that at least we have a little bit of time right now. But I'm not going to speak to you as a candidate. I did run 2 years ago. I think we scared them a little bit because despite this concern about, oh, we're going to have so much money in judicial elections, I don't think I even had $10,000. But you know what I did get? I talked to a lot of people and I explained what is going on in our judicial system and what's going on as an attorney. And you know what? They understand it right away. And so they turned around and gave me 48.5% of the vote. That's what really scares them. Why is this an important issue? Why is this an important issue now? How many people know that we've been supposed to be electing our judges ever since we've been a state for over 150 years? But we don't, do we? We don't. You know why? Because the judges on the highest level, the Supreme Court, control their own election rules. And those rules have been fashioned in such a way, many believe, with that little caveat, that basically ensures that only the incumbents win. Well, is that really true? Well, let's take a look. I ran for the Court of Appeals. In the entire history of the Court of Appeals, not a single judge sitting on that court, past or present, has ever first been elected by the people. Not one. Not one. And what does our Constitution say, by the way? That's important, isn't it? Quote, judges shall be elected by the voters from the area from which they are to serve. Article 6, Section 7. Do we believe in our Constitution? Yeah. You know what I think we need to get back to? If we want to have, you know, why am I doing this? I don't want to do it. I have 4 children. I was dealing with some other health things 2 years ago. Why am I doing it? Because the branch of government that has been dragging this country in the wrong direction is the judicial branch. You care about pro-life? You care about children? What branch of government gave us the Doe versus Gomez decision here in Minnesota and says, not only are we going to say abortion is okay, but guess what, taxpayers? You have to pay for it. You don't like it? Tough. What branch gave us that? Tell me in the Constitution where there's the authority to bail out private banks and use public money to do it. Where is that? Where in our Constitution is the authority to give us, here's the Constitution. You know this little document? I got 30 seconds. Boy, I'm glad I drove 5.5 hours to be here. This Constitution, please read it. Because I don't see anything in here that tells us that we need a health care bill this big to solve a problem that we should be able to fix like this. I wish I had the opportunity to speak with you more. If I get a chance, please do. You can visit my website, which is griffith4judge.com. I don't even know that much if I'm running, but I do think you need to understand this issue. If you did, there is no way you would vote to lose your right to vote. When has it ever benefited the people when they lost their right to vote? Thank you. Yeah.